been a wonderful journey, but the journey continues. I want you to remember what is it we are doing. Together, we are trying to make Dominica the best place to live, the best place to work, and the best place to enjoy life. That is why we've been talking about jobs for young people. That is why we've been talking about better distribution of social services. That is why we have been doing the analysis, we have been planning for the future, and we have been presenting to you in ways that you can understand very clearly what are the next steps and what are the solutions to the problems that we face in Dominica. We spent the campaign for this election doing that. And we succeeded in running the cleanest political campaign in the history of this country. And we are still standing. I know you're proud of what we did, because what we did for you, and we did for the future of Dominica, because we have a mission to change what is called politics in Dominica for good. So starting tonight, as we say thanks, I don't want you to look at us and to refer to us as politicians. We are your representatives. So when they come looking for politicians, send them elsewhere. Send them to the Labour Party. Because what politicians do seems to be a lot of trickery, a lot of deception, and so on. We are your representatives. We have shown you that we represent you faithfully. We are honest. We behave with integrity. We deal with your business very seriously. We take it seriously. And so, we are here tonight to thank each and every one of you. All of you who are part of constituency associations and party groups, all of you who left your homes because you wanted to be part of some fundraising effort, or you just wanted to come to a meeting, you wanted to be at one of our forums. You wanted to be there supporting what we were doing for you at our beloved Dominica. We thank you very much for it. All of you who put your knees on the floor at night, who did that in the morning, who did that in the midday, who prayed ceaselessly for the success of our work together, I want to thank you in a very special way. I want to thank the people who put their hands in their pockets, who dug deep to give us the support we needed to carry this through. I want to thank the bus drivers who made sacrifices and who moved us around in safety. I want to thank all of the young people who voted for the first time and voted for change, because they recognize the future ahead of them has to be better than what they have been seeing over the past 5, 10, 15 years. I want to thank our service providers, those who were responsible for setting up our events, our campaign management team, our trustees, our management team, our candidates. What a wonderful group of people. 21 standing to represent you, to represent the country. Not asking for anything in return, just coming forward with their talents, their skills, but what God has blessed them with, wanting to work diligently and well for a better Dominica. Part of the journey, before I come to that, let me also say, there are a number of people in Dominica that you never hear. They are silent supporters and contributors to this movement to change. And we want to thank them in a very big way. Because they are all. You will not see them here, you will not hear them, but they're doing their own bit for change, and we thank them very much for that. And I also want to thank the children, the young children, who have been following our campaign for change. And there's a little boy, Joshua Price's little boy. Right? He knows already that he's going to vote for the last member. He knows already he's going to vote for the last member. That's who he's going to vote for. Many children around like that. One of them, we want a radio thought one night. And he asked his mother, what is a radio thought? So she explained to him and he said, okay, how much money do I have in my piggy bank? And when they decided, they said, okay, I want to give $100. And the mother brought his $100. It will be years and years before he can vote, but he has already identified with something that means something to his parents, so it means something to him, and he too is standing for change. And there are many little children like that, like the young man, the young boy I met coming up the step tonight. He wanted to say something, and that's why I lifted him up to the microphone so he could say, change is a must. It is for the little children of this country we stand. If we don't do something about this dominator today, they will inherit a nightmare. And so, we are ready. In the current circumstances of our commitment to rescue and to rebuild our beloved Dominica, I am here tonight to tell you, we do not concede to corruption. We do not concede to bribery. We do not concede to theft of general elections. And on this journey to make Dominica the best, we will continue to keep it real by calling things by their correct name. Skullduggery is skullduggery. It is not a virtue. And we will not elevate skullduggery to a virtue by congratulating those who succeed by dishonest means. Don't ask me to do it. Don't beg me to do it. It will not be done. I don't deal with your business that way. We operate at a higher level of honesty and probity. Under the weight of one, Dominican Labour Party bribery of Dominicans at home and abroad to vote in contravention of our electoral laws, under the weight of the fraudulent manipulation of voter qualification provisions, and under the weight of the disregard of the Electoral Commission for its constitutional responsibilities, the electoral process failed the people of Dominica in the election of December 8, 2014. It is important you understand what happened. We are not responsible as politicians, as representatives of the people, for the conduct of the election. In our democracy, in our system, that responsibility for the conduct of election falls to a body, a constitutional body called the Electoral Commission. And the Electoral Commission under the Constitution is asked to operate independently in the public interest of Dominica. So how we vote, the circumstances in which we vote, etc., are set up and are monitored by the Electoral Commission. Before the vote on December 8th, for a few weeks before that, you heard the voice of Shermaine Green Brown on the radio telling you what bribery was. telling you that bribery was an election offense, it was a criminal offense. Telling you that cheating was a criminal offense, an election offense. I'm telling you what the penalties for bribery and cheating were. Sherman Green Brown was not just doing that. She was paid by the Electoral Commission to put out notices on the Electoral Commission's behalf for the benefit of all the people of Dominica to understand what should happen and what should not happen in an election. And yet, the same Electoral Commission has stood back as the Labour Party has violated Section 55 of the House of Assembly Elections Act that speaks about bribery of voters. And in case you have any difficulty understanding that, let me be clear. Bribery is about giving what the law defines as a valuable contribution in exchange for your vote. All of the Dominican brothers and sisters living overseas who received plane tickets and spending money were in receipt of valuable contributions from the Labour Party for their vote, and they were therefore bribed to vote in the election. That is a criminal offence, that is an election offence, and that is enough to set aside the results of the election in a number of constituencies across Dominica. Number two. The Labour Party also engaged in this election in an offence called treating. T-R-E-A-T-I-N-G. What is treating? Well, you treat somebody. You give them something. You give them food, you give them entertainment, etc. The law says you cannot do that to entice people or to encourage people to vote for you. So what did the Labour Party do? The Labour Party brought in a whole set of foreign artists, international artists, paying them hundreds of thousands of dollars per night to entertain people at their rallies. When these international artists come to Dominica and you have to go to see them, you have to dig your hand deep into your pocket to find money to pay to go and see them. But they were available for the people of Dominica to see for free. And that is treating within the meaning of the House of Assembly Elections Act at Section 56. We did not make the laws. We did not write the Constitution of Dominica. We in the United Workers' Party in Dominica. But we understand what the provisions are. And since we are a rule of law party, since we are a party that understands the provisions of our Constitution and our election laws, we say that what happened in this election is not right. The Labour Party has abused the process, has flouted the law, has broken every single aspect of the code of conduct from the Christian Council that we as party side. So they broke the law, the House of Assembly Elections Act. They indulged in the criminal election offense of bribery, the criminal election offense of treating, and therefore they misbehaved. Therefore, they are not your legitimate government because they have gotten there by dishonest means. So what do? We have participated in the process. We knew there were risks in participating in the process because we didn't see any effort on the part of the Electoral Commission to clean the voters' list and to give us ID cards. But we had a choice to make. Were we going to boycott the elections and leave all 21 seats to Roosevelt, Sherry, and his gang in our parliament? Or were we going to make an effort and try to beat the bribery, be in a treaty with your votes and win the election. We were able to do that in some cases. We were defeated in other cases. But this is a flawed election, and the result should not stand. But the only way the result will not stand is if the people of Dominica, having recognized that the power in people is greater than the people in power, stand up and do something about it. You can no longer leave it to us. You can no longer leave it to your representatives alone to advocate on your behalf. Your country needs you now to determine what is right and what can continue as honest practice in our election business in the Commonwealth of Dominica. Because if you don't get involved, this practice of bribing voters, this practice of cheating voters, which is criminal and which is against the laws of Dominica, is going to continue forever and ever, amen. And you, the free people of Dominica, will never ever be able to change your government again. And changing your government is an important part of our democracy. It's an important part of the freedom that we enjoy as a part of the civilized world. This afternoon, we went to the Electoral Commission office. We had announced last night that we were going to be there. And we were going to be there to ask questions about the conduct of the poll. The same poll that in which they tried to steal, they have stolen Grandfort away from the candidate, Dr. Thompson Fowler. We wanted to ask some questions to the chairman of the Electoral Commission and the chief elections officer about irregularities that we saw at work that caused Thompson Fontaine to have the seat cheated from him. They knew we were coming. They called the police to make sure that the people of Dominica did not get anywhere close to the electoral office. They blocked the road at 30 Lane Junction. They blocked the road by the Methodist Church. They blocked the road by Macmillan Gas Station. They blocked the road by Fortune, even though there is no traffic that can go that way inside. They blocked the road there so that people could not come. And when we arrived at the barricade at the Methodist Church going on the road, they told us only 3 people are allowed past the barricade. So the people of Dominica this afternoon were being told they had no right to go to visit their Electoral Commission office to ask questions and to get answers from the election officials that they employ to do their work. I want you to understand clearly what we're talking about, because this country belongs to all of us. And we have a situation right now where Roosevelt's carrot has decided, no, it is not the people's country, it is my country, and I am Roosevelt's carrot. This is Roosevelt's carrot's country, and he's going to use the police, he's going to use the institutions of state to make sure you understand your place. We are here tonight and saying thanks to you to tell you that your place is the place reserved for who is in charge of Dominica, because you collectively are in charge of your country. You will decide who sits in your parliament, you will decide who your government will be, and no Roosevelt's carry will prevent you from doing your business and from asking questions. So, eventually, the people were able to make their way to the outside of the commission building on the road. What happened after that was very interesting. Three of us went in to see the chief elections officer and the chairman of the commission. They knew we were coming in. But we arrived there now, they said, oh, the three can come in, and the three come in. And then they say, then we learn that they're not there. So we said, we wait. So we waited. And while we were waiting, of course, the crowd had gathered and began to get restless. We spoke to them periodically, kept everybody calm. The police then told us we had an illegal gathering outside of the office. There is no way we can see these officers this afternoon, and therefore I, as leader of the group, should disperse the crowd. I said to the police, we came here for a purpose. The officials knew we were coming here, and the reason you are here in such large numbers, some people have riot here at the back waiting to come out because they expected that they were here peacefully, and there was no incident, there was no confrontation at all. We came and we left. They were telling us at that point that the gathering was illegal and we should disperse. I told them, we are going to wait until 4 o'clock because that is when business closes, 4 o'clock. So if they're not there by 4 o'clock, then I will speak to the crowd and we will disperse. So 4 o'clock came and they had not arrived. For us and this group of people, the leadership of the United Workers Party, we are going to the Electoral Commission on Monday morning. Now, we want to be clear about a few things. You heard Joseph Isaac a while ago. He told you we don't want the olive branch, to the olive tree you want. Because the tree has many branches. And he told you some of the things we need branches for. Our priority right now is to make sure that the electoral list is thoroughly cleaned within a reasonable period of time. It cannot be more than 6 months. Cannot be more than 6 months. We want a clean list. We want that clean list by way of complete re-registration of voters in Dominica. And we want ID cards for voting as well. Whatever legislation needs to be amended must be amended as soon as Parliament opens, so that we can move on with the people's business. The road we went down before, we are not going down that road again. There will not be another election in Dominica without electoral reform, and we're starting now to make sure that happens. Pay attention to what is happening. Understand the importance of your role as citizens of this country. Understand your role. And understand what is in front of us right now. Let me be clear. There is quite a bit of confusion in front of me, and a lot of talking about protest action tomorrow. The protest action tomorrow that people are talking about has to do with the swearing of ministers of the government. I just want to repeat. The leadership of the United Workers Party, being fully aware of the involved in contesting elections with a tainted process, went into the election nonetheless in order to prevent a situation where one party would have gone ahead with the election if we boycotted to hold the 21 seats in the parliament. We felt that we could have succeeded against the odds and given the people of Dominica a government that they deserve. It did not work out, but we participated in the process. Therefore, we do not have any moral authority, as far as I'm concerned, to prevent the swearing of ministers who came through that tainted process. And so I am not in support of any demonstration that will take place tomorrow. You understand what I'm saying? Our work is different. We have to work to get what we did not have in this election, which is what caused us to be where we are right now. But we must get on to it and do it now. That is why we're going to the Electoral Commission office on Monday morning. Those who wish to protest tomorrow are free to do so. I will not be there because I do not have any moral authority to say that ministers who came through the very process that we came through should not be sworn in. We have a legal challenge ahead of us, and some of these ministers and some of these elected representatives as of the election of Monday are going to be challenged in the court. We have 21 days to file petitions because we are satisfied that there was enough bribery and enough treating in this election to set it aside. So understand clearly what we are doing and understand the steps that we are taking. We do not want to get ahead of ourselves. First responsibility is to engage with the Electoral Commission that is responsible for elections in Dominica, so that they give us answers to the questions that we have. A number of other matters will come up as we go through those steps, but you have to stay with us, and you have to be prepared to give your support when you're called out to give your support. I have given you the commitment that I will always endeavor with this United Workers Party team, Dominica, to lead you with integrity, to lead you with honesty, and to lead you well. To level with you, to let you understand clearly what you are doing and why you are doing it. And that is why I'm spending so much time on this tonight. I want you to be clear in your mind why it is necessary for us to go back to the Electoral Commission on Monday morning. And why it is important moving ahead, that when we get to Parliament of Dominica, we will not have the divisive Speaker of the House of Assembly. We are saying tonight that Alex Boyd Knight must be removed from the Speaker's chair, and she must make way for someone who is more balanced and who is more impartial. Mrs. Skerrick now shares our vision that we must become the best place to live, the best place to work, and the best place to enjoy life. In the best place to live, the best place to work, and the best place to enjoy life, there is no place for a speaker who is that divisive, who is that cantankerous, and who has shown so much disrespect for the legitimately elected members of the opposition in the last 15 years. Change is must. We also expect Mrs. Skerrick will agree, right, it is agreed in other parts of the civilized world, that a two-term limit has to be imposed for any prime minister from any party in Dominica. We want all economic citizenship passports to be gazetted. We want the name of the buyer, the amount paid, the name of the agent, and the commission made on the sale. Additionally, the government has to regulate how much commission can be made on the sale of our passports. If they intend to continue selling our passports, we have some different ideas in mind, but we have some ideas on how they should fix what is going on right now. We want the secrecy around petrol to be explained, and we want it opened up to scrutiny of the members of the Parliament of Dominica who are duly elected to serve the people of Dominica. And I will tell you why. Venezuela is now getting rid of its Petrocaribe debt. It has started. The Dominican Republic Petrocaribe debt is now in the hands of Goldman Sachs in New York. It was $4 billion. Goldman Sachs paid $1.75 billion for it. And now, instead of answering to Venezuela for the debt, the Dominican Republic will have to answer to a corporate entity in the United States by the name of Goldman Sachs. What you're looking at is the beginning of the dismantling of the Petrocaribe arrangements, where the governments of the region will no longer be able to tell you they have these wonderful cushy arrangements with Venezuela, their friend. Venezuela wants its money. It cannot get it from these islands, so it's going to the United States where it can get it from investment bankers, and these investment bankers will hold the debt. You understand where we're going? We want transparency, we want openness, we want disclosure on the Petrocaribe arrangements. We want the Integrity in Public Office Commission to be allowed to function independently, and all the injunctions, all the obstacles that are in their way, we want them removed immediately so that we can find out what is it Mr. Skerrigan has been up to with the resources of this country that he has used to enrich himself beyond the level where it can be explained by his legal income. We want the procurement bill and the legal professions bill to be passed without further delay. These are some more branches from the olive tree that we want presented to us before we can consider any acceptance of any olive branch from Rousseau's or any of his ministers.